Hello everyone. Okay, in the last lecture we have started the new chapter AM and FM modulation, and we have seen the baseband transmission, its drawback, so why we are using the modulation, need of modulation, and first two needs we have seen. Okay, so in today's lecture we will see the next needs of modulation. So what are the needs of modulation? To reduce the height of antenna, to avoid the mixing of signal, to make multiplexing possible, to increase the range of communication, and to improve the quality of reception. These are the needs of modulation. Okay, so first two needs we have seen in the last lecture, so we will see the next needs of modulation. So next need, it is the to make multiplexing possible. To make multiplexing possible. So what is the multiplexing? First question, it is the what is the multiplexing? In multiplexing, we are transmitting number of signals over the single communication channel. We are transmitting the number of signals over the single communication channel. Okay, so what is the multiplexing? In multiplexing, we are transmitting the number of signals, means more number of signals are transmitted over the single communication channel. Multiplexing, it is the process in which more number of signals are transmitted over the single communication channel. Okay, so this multiplexing, which is possible only by using modulation. This multiplexing, which is possible only by using the modulation. Okay, if you are considering the example as different TV channel frequencies are transmitted at the same time. Okay, different TV channel frequencies are transmitted at the same time. Okay, on the cable TV, we will see the number of channels are transmitted at the same time, or number of channels we are seeing at the same time. Okay. Different TV channels we are seeing at the same time. So this is the example of multiplexing. So what is the multiplexing? Multiplexing, it is the process in which more number of signals are transmitted over the single communication channel, and it is possible by using the modulation. Means multiplexing, which is possible by using the modulation, and we will see the number of TV channel frequency are transmitted at the same time. So this is the example of your multiplexing. So this is the explanation for this multiplexing, why possible by using this modulation. Next one, it is the to increase the range of communication. Next one, it is the to increase the range of communication. The frequency of baseband signal, which is the low. The frequency of baseband signal, which is the low. And this low frequency signal cannot travel for the long distance in a free space. The low frequency signal cannot travel for long distance in a free space or in a air. They are get attenuated. They are get attenuated or suppressed. Okay. The attenuation is reduces with increase in a frequency. Attenuation is reduces with the increase in a frequency. Okay. So they can travel for the longer distance. So when the baseband signal, which is transmitted as it is, then these baseband signals are low frequency signal. And this low frequency signal cannot travel for the long distance. They are get attenuated or they are get suppressed after the short distance. Okay, this attenuation, which is reduces with increase in a frequency. But when we are doing the modulation, at that time they can travel for the long distance. Okay, they can travel for the long distance. So to increase the range of communication, the modulation, which is necessary. To increase the range of communication, the modulation, which is necessary. Next one, it is the to improve the quality of reception. to improve the quality of reception. Okay. So noise, which is major problem in your communication system, the noise which is major problem in your communication system. Okay. So when we are considering the modulations like FM modulation, pulse code modulation, in these modulation techniques, the effect of noise which is reduced. The effect of noise which is reduced. When we are reducing the effect of noise, then it improves the quality of reception. When we are reducing the effect of noise, then the quality of reception which is improves. Then the quality of reception which is improves. Okay. So by using this modulation, we are improving the quality of reception. By using this modulation process, we are improving the quality of reception. So these are the needs of modulation. First need, it is the to reduce the height of antenna. Next one, it is the to avoid the mixing of signal. Next one, it is the to make multiplexing possible. Next one, it is the to increase the range of communication. And next one, it is the to improve quality of reception. These are the needs of your modulation. Next, we see the different types of modulation. We will see the different types of modulation. Okay. So there are three types of modulation. First one, it is the continuous wave modulation, which is nothing but your analog modulation. Next one, it is the pulse modulation. This pulse modulation, which is divided into two types, analog pulse and digital pulse. And last one, it is the digital modulation. There are three types of modulation: analog modulation, pulse modulation and digital modulation. Pulse modulation, which is divided into two types, analog pulse and digital pulse. Okay. So in analog modulation, we will see the amplitude modulation, frequency modulation and phase modulation. In analog modulation, we will see the amplitude modulation, frequency modulation and phase modulation. In pulse modulation, it is divided into two types, analog pulse and digital pulse. Analog pulse examples are PAM, pulse amplitude modulation, pulse width modulation and pulse position modulation. And example of digital pulse modulations are PCM, pulse code modulation, DM, delta modulation, ADM, adaptive delta modulation. These are the digital pulse modulation. Okay. And last ones are digital modulation. The digital modulations are ASK, FSK and PSK. Amplitude shift keying, phase shift keying and frequency shift keying. These are the examples of your digital modulation. So this analog modulation, which is divided into three types, AM, amplitude modulation, FM, frequency modulation, PM, phase modulation. The pulse modulation, which is divided into two types, pulse amplitude modulation, pulse width modulation, pulse position modulation. And digital pulse modulations are PCM, pulse code modulation, delta modulation, adaptive delta modulation. And digital modulation techniques are ASK, amplitude shift keying, frequency shift keying and phase shift keying. These are the examples of your digital modulation. So in this subject, we will see only the analog modulation techniques, that is AM, amplitude modulation, FM, frequency modulation, and we will see only definition of your phase modulation. Okay. So in brief, we will see the analog modulation and frequency modulation. So we will see one by one. We will see first amplitude modulation and then we will see the frequency modulation. So these are the modulation types: analog modulation, pulse modulation and digital modulation. Analog, which is divided into three: amplitude modulation, frequency modulation and phase modulation. Pulse modulation, which is divided into two: analog pulse, digital pulse, PAM, PWM, PPM. Pulse amplitude modulation, pulse width modulation, pulse position modulation, and digital pulse are PCM, pulse code modulation, delta modulation DM, adaptive delta modulation ADM. And digital modulation techniques are amplitude shift keying, frequency shift keying, and phase shift keying. So these are the types of modulation. So first we see what is the amplitude modulation. So first we see definition. So I have told you the one definition that modulation is the process in which one of the parameter of carrier, which it changes according with your modulating signal, and one of the parameter is either amplitude, either frequency, or either phase. So when we are considering the definition of amplitude modulation, at that time in amplitude modulation, the amplitude which is changes. Okay, when we are considering the frequency modulation, at that time frequency which is changes, and when we are considering the phase modulation, at that time phase of the carrier signal which is changes according with your modulating signal. So we will see the definition of amplitude modulation. In amplitude modulation or amplitude modulation, it is the process in which amplitude of carrier signal which is changes according with your modulating signal. Amplitude of carrier signal varies or changes according with your modulating signal. So in amplitude modulation, which parameter of carrier signal which is changes? Amplitude. And amplitude which is changes according with your modulating signal. So amplitude of carrier signal which is changes according with your modulating signal. So this is the amplitude modulation. So see in a figure. So first a signal, it is the modulating signal. This modulating signal, which is nothing but your baseband signal or information signal. I have already told you that this modulating signal, which is the low frequency signal. So this low frequency signal, which is shown in figure. Okay. And amplitude of this modulating signal is EM. So we are denoting the amplitude as E or by using the V. Okay. So it is the EM, or you consider that it is the VM. Okay. So this is the modulating signal. Next one is the carrier signal. The carrier signal, it is the high frequency sinusoidal signal. And the amplitude of this carrier signal, it is the EC. So see in the definition, what is the definition? Amplitude modulation, it is the process in which amplitude of carrier signal which is changes according with your modulating signal. So amplitude of this carrier signal which is changes with your according with your modulating signal. Amplitude of this carrier signal varies or changes according with your modulating signal. So at the output we are getting the modulated signal. Which is the AM signal. So this is the amplitude modulated signal. Which parameter which is changes? Amplitude. Okay. And according which is changes? It changes according with your modulating signal. Okay. So in amplitude modulation, the amplitude of carrier signal varies or changes according with your modulating signal. So there are three parts. First one it is the no signal. Second one it is the positive, and last one it is the negative. Okay. So there is no signal. So the carrier which is as it is transmitted. See in a figure, there are three parts. No signal which is transmitted. then the positive half cycle and then the negative half cycle. So at there is a no signal, so as it is carrier which is transmitted. And next one, it is the high amplitude. At that time the carrier signal which is having the high amplitude means carrier signal which is changes according with your modulating signal. And for the negative half cycle, again the carrier signal which is amplitude of carrier signal which is reduces, means what, again this carrier signal which is changes according with your modulating signal. So this is the amplitude modulation. So EC which is shown in figure, minus EC which is shown in figure, EM plus EC which is shown in figure, minus EM plus EC which is shown in figure. Also we have shown the V max, so the see the distance from V minimum and V maximum. So see the distance of V minimum. So this is the V minimum distance which is shown by arrow, and V max which is also shown by arrow. So distance of V minimum and V maximum you will see in a figure. So this is the amplitude modulation. So see again same amplitude modulation, but we are considering the only positive half cycle and negative half cycle. The information which is absent we are seeing in a first diagram. In second diagram we will see only positive half cycle and negative half cycle. So the see the modulating signal, see the carrier signal, and lastly see the modulated signal, that is the AM signal. Only no information signal which is only absent here. Okay, so this is the amplitude modulated signal. It is the amplitude modulated signal. Next one, it is the frequency modulation. Next one, it is the frequency modulation. So what is the frequency modulation? In frequency modulation, it is the process in which frequency of carrier signal varies or changes according with your modulating signal is called as a frequency modulation. It is the process in which frequency of carrier signal varies or changes according with your modulating signal. Okay, so in this frequency modulation there are two parameters are constant. Which two parameters are constant? Amplitude and phase. In amplitude modulation, which two parameters are constant of frequency and phase? Which parameter which is changes? Amplitude in amplitude modulation. And which two parameters are constant? Frequency and phase. And in frequency modulation, which parameter which is constant of amplitude and phase? And which parameter which is changes? It is the frequency. So frequency of carrier signal varies or changes according with your modulating signal. So see in the figure, first one it is the modulating signal. First one it is the modulating signal. Okay, which having the amplitude of EM. Next one it is the carrier signal. Next one it is the carrier signal. And last one it is the modulated signal, that is the FM signal, frequency modulated signal. So there are again three parts. First one, it is the information is absent. Next one, it is the positive, and next one, it is the negative. When the information which is absent, at that time as it is carrier signal which is transmitted. As it is carrier signal which is transmitted. When there is a positive half cycle, then the high frequency carrier which is transmitted. When there is a positive half cycle, then the high frequency carrier signal which is transmitted. And when there is a negative half cycle, at that time the low frequency carrier signal which is transmitted. Low frequency carrier signal which is transmitted means what? The frequency of this carrier signal which is changes according with your modulating signal. When the information which is absent, then as it is carrier signal which is transmitted. When there is a positive half cycle, then high frequency carrier signal which is transmitted. And when the negative half cycle is there, then the low frequency carrier signal which is transmitted. Means what? Which parameter which is changes here? the frequency of carrier signal which changes according with your modulating signal. So definition, it is the process in which frequency of carrier signal varies or changes according with your modulating signal. It is the frequency modulation. In this process, there are two parameters are constant, amplitude and phase, which is the constant. So this is the frequency modulation. So again, see the frequency modulation for only two cycles, that is the for positive half cycle and negative half cycle. Information which is absent, which is present in a last slide, and in this slide only two half cycles are there, positive half cycle and negative half cycle. So for positive half cycle, we are transmitting high frequency signal, and for the negative half cycle, we are transmitting the low frequency signal. When this signal which is received at the receiver side, so for the high frequency signal, we are considering the positive half cycle which is transmitted, and for the low frequency signal, we are considering the negative half cycle which is transmitted. So how we are detecting at the receiver, when high frequency carrier signal which is comes, at that time we are considering that the high amplitude signal which is transmitted, and when the low frequency carrier signal which is comes, at that time we are considering the negative half cycle or low frequency signal, low amplitude signal which is transmitted. So this is the frequency modulation. Okay, so on today's lecture we have seen the need of modulations and amplitude modulation and frequency modulation. So we will see once again. So what are the needs of modulation? To reduce the height of antenna, to avoid the mixing of signal, to make multiplexing possible. Next one, it is the improve quality of reception, and to make multiplexing possible and increase the range of communication. Okay, next we have seen the types of modulation: analog modulation, pulse modulation and digital modulation. Analog modulation techniques are amplitude modulation, frequency modulation and phase modulation. Pulse modulation techniques are analog pulse, digital pulse. Analog pulse modulations are PAM, PWM, PP. Digital pulse modulations are PCM, DM and ADM. And last one is the digital pulse modulation. Digital pulse modulations are PCM, DM and ADM. And last it is the digital modulation. And digital modulation techniques are ASK, FSK and PSK. Next we have seen the amplitude modulation and frequency modulation. In amplitude modulation, it is the process in which amplitude of carrier signal which is varies or changes according with your modulating signal. It is the amplitude modulation. And what is the frequency modulation? It is the process in which frequency of carrier signal varies or changes according with your modulating signal. So this is the frequency modulation. In next lecture, we will see what is the phase modulation.